إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبد الله تعالى ورسوله، صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وقل الحق من ربكم فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر، إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها، إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها، وإن يستغيثوا يغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه، بئس الشراب وساءت مرتفقا، إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات إنا لا نضيع أجر من أحسن عملا، أولئك لهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتهم الأنهار، يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب، ويلبسون ثيابا خضرا من سندس وإستبرق متكئين فيها على الأرائك، نعم الثواب وحسنت مرتفقا. صدق الله العلي العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer and nourisher. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread on his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, firstly, it is incumbent upon us to thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this noble and auspicious day that He has blessed us with. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said in regard to the virtue of this day that it is the best of days upon which the sun has risen. It is the best of days upon which the sun has risen. فِيهِ خُلِقَ آدَمُ. In it, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was created on this very day. وَفِيهِ أُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ. And on this very day, he was admitted, he was granted entry into Jannah. وَفِيهِ أُخْرِجَ مِنْهُ. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. And likewise, it was on this very day. It was on Yawm al-Jum'ah. It was on the day of Jum'ah. It was on Friday that Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was taken out of Jannah and sent to this world. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in this blessed day. Firstly, I would like to thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity that He has blessed me with. And then I enjoin taqwa upon myself and upon all of you all seated here. And that is to fear Almighty Allah, to be conscious of Almighty Allah in every single second of your life. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill all of our hearts with taqwa, accept all of our deeds and forgive all of our sins, even if they be like the froth of the sea. Ameen. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, inshaAllah ta'ala, today's lecture is going to evolve mostly around the three ayat I recited at the very beginning. These three ayat are from Suratul Kahf. And I thought it all the more appropriate because Suratul Kahf has a very distinct relationship to Yawm al-Jum'ah, to the day Friday. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Allah is commanding our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, Allah is commanding him, say, الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. The truth is from your Lord, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal is enjoining upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam الدَّعْوَةِ. Call people towards the truth. Call people towards the way of Allah. Call people towards Islam. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, a fine point to be highlighted here is that if this command was sent to our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we being his ummah, we being his nation, the order naturally is mandatory upon us too. There are so many virtues in regard to this ummah. And the only reason, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, is because of the responsibility. Al-amru bil-ma'roof wa-nahi anil munkar. Enjoining good and forbidding evil. You and I, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we being Muslims, we cannot keep quiet if something evil takes place in front of our eyes. We cannot be satisfied that I am making my 5 salawat in the masjid. I am connected to the masjid. I am connected to Allah. So I do not have to bother about my neighbor. I do not have to bother about my brother in Islam. I do not have to bother about my family. I do not have to bother about my relatives. This is not the mindset of a believer, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. As there are many ayahs in the noble Quran that enjoins us upon ad-da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. In regard to this ayah, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, this is where scholars mention whether ad-da'wah is obligatory upon each and every ummati of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or if only a particular group fulfills this obligation, whether it falls off the rest of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that at all times and at all moments, there has to be a group, there has to be a nation from this ummah, who are inviting people towards good, who enjoin good and forbid evil. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And verily they are the ones who are successful in this world and the hereafter. In another place Allah talks about this ummah. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. You all are the best of nations ever sent to the face of this earth. Why? Because you all enjoin good and forbid evil. Allahu Akbar. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, most of the scholars mention that it is obligatory upon each and every one of us enjoining good and forbidding evil. We cannot keep quiet. Dawah in Allah, calling people towards Allah, it is obligatory upon each and every one of us. Allah talks about the previous nation. لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلون لبئس ما كانوا يفعلون. The people of Banu Israel, the children of Israel, they were cursed. They were cursed by not ordinary people, by the Anbiya, by the tongues of Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam. Isa ibn Maryam, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the reason being, ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْ وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ, that was because they disobeyed Allah, they transgressed the limits of Allah, and كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَمْ مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ, they did not prohibit the evil that was taking place within themselves. They did not prohibit the evil that was taking place in front of their eyes. لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ, and that was indeed the worst thing that they could ever have done. Allahu Akbar. The worst thing. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And may Almighty Allah instill in our hearts this capability to enjoin good and forbid evil. And the best way to do that, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, أُدْعُوا إِلَىٰ سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِدَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ, call towards the way of your Lord with hikmah, والموعدات الحسنة, with hikmah, with wisdom, with diplomacy and good counsel, not with harsh words. This is the guidance given to us by the Quran, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. So coming back to the primary ayah that I recited, قل الحق من ربكم, tell them that الحق is from Allah. And then Allah goes on to say, إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ نَارًا أَحَاطَ بِهِمْ سُرَادِقُهَا. Allahu Akbar. Allah is saying, إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا, we, Allah is talking about Himself, we have prepared لِلظَّالِمِينَ, for those oppressors, نَارًا, a blazing fire. So who are these oppressors, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? Scholars mention the definition of al-dhulm. The definition of al-dhulm, oppression, is وَضْعُ الشَّيْءٍ فِي غَيْرِ مَوْضِعِهِ, is placing something in a place that it does not belong in. You take something from somewhere and you place it somewhere else. And from these oppressions, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the highest in degree is shirk, associating partners unto Allah. Why? Because this heart that has been given to us by Almighty Allah is meant for Him, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, and not meant for any other partner that we associate unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ones who transgress the limits of Allah, they are known as al-zalimun. Why? Because they transgress the prohibitions of Almighty Allah. أَلَا وَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَلِكٍ حِمَىٰ, the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that indeed for every king, he has a sanctuary. A sanctuary is a guarded place where nobody is allowed to enter. It is guarded off and fenced off. Likewise, if no one can enter the sanctuary of a king, أَلَا وَإِنَّ حِمَ اللَّهِ مَحَارِمٌ, indeed the sanctuary of Almighty Allah is all that which He has prohibited. His prohibitions are it is in a sanctuary, it is fenced off. If you cannot think of approaching the sanctuary of a king from this world, how dare we think to get even close to the sanctuary of Almighty Allah? Allah says, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Allah is not talking, do not indulge in the act. Allah is saying, do not even become close to indulging in the act of zina. Do not even become close to it. Don't even think that you can get close to the sanctuary of Almighty Allah. For if you do, you become from the zalimun. You become from the oppressors who have transgressed the limits of Almighty Allah. And for these oppressors, Allah says, we have prepared nara, a blazing fire. Allahu Akbar. A blazing fire, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, In this world, we cannot even imagine holding a matchstick for a second or two. We cannot bear the heat of the fire. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the fire of Jahannam, just imagine with me, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, imagine with me. I'm talking about a matchstick. Okay, go a few scales higher. Think about a forest fire. Think about a petrol bunker blowing up. Think about that blazing fire. Have you heard of forest fires abroad? It covers miles and miles. No types of, even you cannot extinguish it with airplanes. It is that huge. Think about such a fire. Okay? Think about such a fire. Now think about another creation of Almighty Allah, the sun. The sun. The sun, which the heat levels on the sun, it has been recorded to go above 15 million Celsius. Not 100 Celsius, 15 million Celsius. The heat of the sun. Okay, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, comparing all of these, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that you mention any type of heat from the dunya, all of this heat is juz'un min sab'een juz'a. It is just 1/70th, one part from the fire of Jahannam, from the 70 parts of Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. If we cannot imagine a fire, when I say 15 million Celsius, these digits don't run in our mind. The fire of Jahannam is 70 times greater than that. Just imagine how much of fear, how much of taqwa this must drag into our hearts, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Hadith in Tirmidhi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in regard to the fire of Jahannam, that the fire of Jahannam was fanned for 1,000 years. For 1,000 years until it became a blazing red. Until it became a blazing bright red. And then afterwards it was fanned for another 1,000 years until it became sparkling white. Until it became pure white. And then it was fanned for another 1,000 years until it became pitch black. The fire of Jahannam is pitch black, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Allah says in the ayah, نَارًا أَحَاطَ بِهِمْ سُرَادِقُهَا. These oppressors, the ones who transgress the limits of Allah, they will be put into this fire. This fire where its walls will be of fire, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. In Jahannam, the walls are of fire. The food is of fire. The drink is of fire. The inhabitants will be roasting in Jahannam, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Allah says, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. A group from this ummah will be in Jannah. And another group, sadly, unfortunately, they will be in the blazing fire. They will be in this blazing fire. Hot lava. They will be in this blazing fire. And then, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in regard to the adab in Jahannam, I'm not going to go into the details of the adab. Just look at one. The least. The person who is being punished the least. It will be asked from him, O slave, if you are given this whole dunya, this whole world, not one country, not one locality, the whole world, if it is going to be given to you, would you ransom yourself with that dunya to escape from the least punishment in Jahannam? He would jump and say, I would. I would. He would not hesitate a second. Today we hanker behind this dunya. We are amassing millions. We do not know where the source is from, whether it is halal or haram. On that day the whole dunya will be given and he would want to ransom himself to escape the fire of Jahannam, to escape the adab of Jahannam. Allah talks about this least punishment. Allah says, وَلَئِن مَسَّتْهُمْ نَفْحَةٌ مِّنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّكَ. That on that day, when he is put into Jahannam, a nafha from the azab of Allah, a nafha, the word used here is nafha, will touch him. Now the word nafha is an Arabic term, nafha and lafha. Lafha means a hot wind. Lafha. Nafha, on the other hand, is a cool wind. وَلَئِن مَسَّتْهُمْ نَفْحَةٌ مِّنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّكَ. This man will not be put into Jahannam. Rather, he will be miles away from Jahannam. For we can understand, if he's going to be close to Jahannam, it will be a hot wind. If Allah is saying, a cool wind will touch him from Jahannam. From Jahannam, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, it indicates that he is a few miles away from Jahannam. The minute this cool wind from Jahannam touches him, وَلَئِن مَسَّتْهُمْ, it barely touches him. It barely touches him. It does not go over him completely. Rather, it grazes by him. He will scream out. He will scream out, يَا وَيْلَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. He will say, it is as if I am in wild. You know what wail is? Wail is a part of Jahannam. That Jahannam itself is afraid of that part. Allahu Akbar. It is a part in Jahannam that Jahannam itself dreads that part. Jahannam is scared of that part. Jahannam seeks protection from Allah from that part. Wail. You say it is as if I am in wail. Whilst in reality he is miles and miles away from Jahannam, and it is a cool wind that grazed across by him. May Almighty Allah save us all. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in regard to the food of the inhabitants of Jahannam, what is it? Allah says, إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُّومِ طَعَامُ الْأَثِيمِ كَالْمُهْلِ يَغْلِي فِي الْبُطُونِ. The food of the people of Jahannam will be fruits from the tree of Zakum. What is this tree? The roots are from the very bottom of Jahannam. It has طَلْعُهَا كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُوسُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. The head of the tree is like the heads of devils. It is a thorny tree. The more he eats it, it tears apart his intestines. His body is like on fire. It is as if he is drinking lava. This is the only food the inhabitants of Jahannam will get. They will be thirsty. They will ask for water. They will ask for water. Water will not be given, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Rather, something called ghislin will be given. What is ghislin? Ghislin, boiling pus. Boiling pus, blood, vomit. This is what will be given to the inhabitants of Jahannam to quench their thirst. Once they eat the fruits of Zakum, the intestines are tearing apart and they want to quench it. They ask for water and this is what they will get, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Allahu Akbar. Coming back to the ayah. وَإِن يَسْتَغِيثُوا يُغَاثُوا وَإِن يَسْتَغِيثُوا. Now these people who will be in Jahannam, they will cry out for help. وَإِن يَسْتَغِيثُوا. They will cry out for help, the inhabitants of Jahannam. The denizens of the hellfire, they will cry out for help. And how will they cry out? To whom they will cry out? They will cry out to the Khazanati Jahannam, the guardians of Jahannam, 19 angels in total. The head of them, his name is Malik. His name is Malik. They will call out to these angels. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ فِي النَّارِ لِخَزَنَةِ جَهَنَّمْ أُدْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ يُخَفِّفْ عَنَّا يَوْمًا مِّنَ الْعَذَابِ. The people who are in Jahannam, they will call out to these angels, please pray to Allah, invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He lightens the punishment for us on this day. Then those angels will question them. قَالُوا أَوَلَمْ تَكُ تَأْتِيكُمْ رُسُلُكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Did not the messengers of Allah come to you with their proofs? Did not the people come to you calling towards Allah? Did they not come to you and warn you? They will say, قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. They will say, of course, they came, but we did not take heed. Rather, we were too busy hankering behind this dunya. Then the angels will say, فَدْعُوا وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ. Keep on invoking, keep on calling, keep on supplicating. And all of the du'as, all of the invocation of the people of Jahannam, the kuffar, are nothing that other than they are in misguidance. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Next, now after speaking to the angels, they will try calling out to the head of the angels. They will call out the head of the angels and they'll say, وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكُ. They will call out to Malik, who will be the head of the angels. They say, the Quran ayah, وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقُضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكُ. They say, O Malik, please, please let our Lord, let Allah decide something in behalf of us. We are suffering. Malik will reply, إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. You are going to abide here in this Jahannam forever and ever. You are going to dwell there. Next, they will look at the people of Jannah. Allahu Akbar. May Almighty Allah make us from the people of Jannah. They will look at the people of Jannah.
وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَكَكُمُ اللَّهِ.
The people of Jahannam will call out to the people of Jannah, their friends, their relatives, who used to call them but now they are in Jahannam. They say, please, pour some water, give us some water, or give us something that Allah has blessed you with. And the people of Jannah will look at them. They will feel sad, but then they'll say,
قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُمَا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ.
They'll say that indeed, we cannot help you, we cannot do anything. Allah has made these two things haram upon you people, upon the kuffar, upon the people of Jahannam.
الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَهْوًا وَلَعِبًا.
Those who took the deen of Allah as play and amusement.
وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا.
This temporary life of dunya deceived them and fooled them.
فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ.
On this day, we shall forget them.
كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا.
Just as how they forgot the day that they are going to meet their Lord. The day that they are going to meet all of this.
وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ.
And they used to reject the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Finally, the people of Jahannam will turn to Allah.
They will turn to the Malik. They will turn to Ar-Rahman. They will turn to Ar-Rahim. The most merciful, the most beneficent, and they will pray. رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِقْوَتُنَا وَكُنَّا قَوْمًا ضَالِّينَ. رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا مِنْهَا فَإِنْ عُدْنَا فَإِنَّا ظَالِمُونَ.
They pray to Allah. Ya Allah, this suffering has overcome us. We cannot bear it. Give us a chance, take us out, and we will never go back to the evil that we were in. For if we do, we would be from the people of the oppressors, from the people who oppress themselves. They turn to Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. And you know what Allah will say, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam.
قَالَ اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. قال اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون.
Allah will reply, you will remain
ولا تكلمون,
and do not speak to me. Allahu Akbar. Allah save us all. Allah save us all.
ولا تكلمون,
and do not talk to me. This is the state of the people of Jahannam, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. The ayah goes on now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in regard, now Allah has spoken about the people of Jahannam. Allah says in the ayah,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ إِنَّا لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا.
Allah spoke about the people of Jahannam. Now Allah starts about the people of Jannah. And this is generally the style of the Quran, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. What is the style? What is the style?
Al-Khawf wa-Raja.
Fearing Almighty Allah, likewise hoping in Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the two wings of a believer. A believer needs hope and a believer needs fear. These are the two wings that would help him to fly directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he does not have one wing, he falls. He needs to have fear of Almighty Allah, likewise hope in Almighty Allah. Allah says in regard to himself,
نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم.
O Prophet, inform the people that indeed I am the most forgiving, the most merciful. Next ayah, وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. Just as he says, forgiving and most merciful, your hopes rise. وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. But likewise, indeed my punishment is the most painful punishment, the most painful torment. So you don't play games with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. It is upon us to bring in the khawf of Allah, likewise hope in Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in regard to those who believe in Allah, those who have brought in iman, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they do good deeds. They do good deeds. إِنَّا لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. We shall never ever put their good deeds, put those who have perfected their amal, we shall not put them to waste. إِنَّا لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. We shall not put the rewards of those who have perfected their deeds into waste. Allah says, and then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ, and for them will be, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ, for them will be gardens of Aden. We hear the word Aden, we think Eden. But in reality what Aden means, perpetual residence. They will be living forever and ever in these gardens. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارِ. Rivers will flow beneath them. يُحَلَّوْنَ فِيهَا مِنْ أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ وَيَلْبَسُونَ ثِيَابًا خُضْرًا مِنْ سُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ. Now in regard to this ayah, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he's written a beautiful book, حَادِ الْأَرْوَاحِ إِلَى بِلَادِ الْأَفْرَاحِ. It is a fantastic read, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. If there is a translation available, I advise you all and implore you all, read the book. For it is a fantastic read. It takes you to worlds of ecstasy. Allahu Akbar. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, in that, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, he describes Jannah. He describes Jannah. He says, if you were to ask about Jannah, if you were to ask about the gardens of Jannah, about the palaces of Jannah, then let them know that the palaces of Jannah are made of gold, are made of emerald, are made of jewel, are made of silver, are made of pearl. The bricks, one brick is gold and then silver. You don't use cement in Jahannam, rather musk, saffron. This is what is holding the bricks of Jannah in place. You can go all around the world and look at all the modern architecture. Have you ever heard of someone building a palace within one pearl? Allahu Akbar. The palace that will be gifted to Khadija radiallahu anha is a palace made out of one pearl. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went on Mi'raj, Rasulullah was shown a beautiful palace made of gold, completely gold. And there was a beautiful maiden washing herself beside that palace. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then asked, to whom does this palace belong to, or for whom is this palace? Then the reply was given that it is going to be given or gifted to a noble youngster from the Quraysh. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he assumed that it has to be me. This palace is for me. He assumed. And then the reply was given, no, this palace is for Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Beautiful palaces, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, made of gold and silver. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah now says, if you ask about the soil of Jannah, it is made of musk. If you ask about the rocks of Jannah, it is made of jewels and pearls and diamonds. If you ask about the trees of Jannah, the trunks of the trees are made of gold. The leaves of the tree are softer than silk. And when the cool wind blows, a beautiful and soothing music comes from those leaves, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. The fruits of Jannah, each bite will have a different taste.
Allah, look at the rivers of Jannah, rivers of luscious and sweet honey, softer than silk, sweeter than anything in this world, rivers of milk, pure white milk, rivers of wine, wine that does not cause headaches, nor give you intoxication, sweet, luscious wine. In regard to the women of Jannah, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he says, the same book, in this world, so many things, wars are being waged. Wars are being waged over whom? Over at times over one woman. And who is she? Hurul Tin. She is not from the Hurul Ain, she is from the Hurul Tin. The woman made of dirt, made of clay, made of sand. If she can be so beautiful, then imagine the beauty of the Hurul Ain, who is made, whose essence is from saffron. Allahu Akbar. Scholars mentioned, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that the Hurul Ain, they're made of musk, they're made of saffron, they're made of camphor. All of these beautiful things, they are free from menses, they are free from sweat, they are free from bile, they are free from phlegm, they are free from saliva. All good things, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, young, full-breasted, celestial maiden at your beck and call. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. And then now, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, he mentions something very beautiful. With that, I'll wrap up the lecture, inshaAllah ta'ala. Now you just imagine with me, just bring this scene in front of your eyes. Even though in reality you cannot imagine Jannah, it is a place where no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard about, nor has it crossed the minds of any human being. But just try to imagine. InshaAllah ta'ala, when we will be in Jannah, when all of us, when we are in Jannah, we will be seated by the rivers of Jannah. We will be drinking, using goblets, drinking milk from the rivers, drinking wine from the rivers and enjoying. We hear about legends. Umar radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We hear about all of them. On that day we will be with them. We will be with them in reality. We will be talking to them. We will be talking to our family and relatives. Enjoying the beautiful scenes of Jannah. At that time, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions this beautiful narration. A caller will call out, at that time a caller will call out, Ya Ahl al-Jannah. A caller will call out, Ya Ahl al-Jannah. Immediately when this call falls on the ears of the people, their hearts will immediately fill with fear. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to take us out of Jannah? Why are we being addressed? Why are we being called? A caller will call out, Ya Ahl al-Jannah. Then everybody, all of the Jannatis will turn around to see who is this caller. Just imagine, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, just imagine. And then this caller will say, O people of Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has extended an invitation to all of you all, that he wants you all to come and visit him. Allahu Akbar. To visit Allah. This angel, the caller, he calls out. And then the people get up, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. All of us, we will get up on that day. We will get up and start moving towards where we are being called. People will be traveling on their conveyances, in their horses, in their flying horses, horses made of rubies and emeralds. Now they travel towards a valley. And when they reach that valley, suddenly a huge light will break out. A huge light. And then the arsh of Allah will be visible to the people of Jannah. And then from all corners, manabir, pulpits will pop up. Pulpits of light, pulpits of gold, pulpits of emeralds, pulpits of pearls will crop up everywhere for the people, for us to sit in, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. And then when we sit in these pulpits, suddenly a huge light will once again break out. And then we will hear, We will hear the voice of Ar-Rahman. We will hear the voice of Ar-Rahim, of our beloved Allah. Ya Ahl al-Jannah, Salamun alaykum. Allah will say Assalamu alaykum to us, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Allah who is Salam himself, he will say Assalamu alaykum. And then what better a reply can be given other than Allahumma anta as-salam wa minka as-salam tabarakta ya al-jalali wal-ikram. Ya Allah, you are as-salam wa minka as-salam, and from you is salam. Tabarakta, you are blessed. Ya al-jalali wal-ikram, oh the possessor of might and power. Allahu Akbar. Then Allah will ask the people of Jannah, oh my slaves, Allah will then say, I wish to look at those who worshipped me without even seeing me. Allahu Akbar. The people who heard about me, who heard about my messenger, they worshipped me without seeing me. They prayed 5 times a day. They made sajda to me without seeing me. Allahu Akbar. And then Allah will say, this is the day of mazid. Ask whatever you want and you shall be granted that. We will all say with one voice, Ya Allah, you have given us everything. Allahu Akbar. You have given us everything in this Jannah. What more can we ask? Allah will say, this is the day of mazid. You ask what you wish. And then we will all say with one voice, Ya Allah, arina wajhak. Ya Allah, show us your blessed and beautiful face. Allahu Akbar. Just imagine this spectacle, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that Allah, who we love so much, we have never seen Him. On that day we will ask, Ya Allah, show Yourself to us. And then Allah will remove all of the veils that are separating Him from us. Allah will remove all of the veils. And then we will be able to look at Allah. Scholars mentioned we will be transfixed in that place for years and years and years and years looking at Allah. Allahu Akbar. Allah will remove the veils and Allah will decree. Allah will that His light should not burn any one of us. And we will be all looking at Allah. And then Allah will talk to every Jannati. Allah will say, oh my slave, oh my beloved slave, you did this on this day and on that day and on that day. This sin on this day and that sin on that day. To which we will confirm. And then Allah will say, if not for my forgiveness, my dear slave, you would not be in this place today. Allahu Akbar, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. This is the beauty and the spectacle of us meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, all of us, we should yearn for that day. We should wish for that day. We should wish to set our eyes on the face of Ar-Rahman, on the face of our beloved Creator, our beloved Maker, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Almighty Allah grant us all the opportunity. May Almighty Allah make us all from the people of Jannah. May Almighty Allah make us all from those who will see Him on the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, bring in taqwa, adopt taqwa, bring in the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness for your sins. Allah is most forgiving, most merciful, and He is ready to forgive all of our sins, even if they be like mountains or like the froth of the sea. Wa akhir da'wa'i anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.